Hello everyone, welcome to the Redmen TV. It is the Uncensored Match Build-Up Show for a game that we hope is going ahead in the FA Cup third round. The earliest we've ever met Shrewsbury in the competition. I've only met them in the fourth round before. So there you go, there's a little...
That's all we know about them.
That's literally it. I mean, we've played them quite a bit. Like, we played them twice, was it last year? Or was it the year before? Was it 2020?
I think it was 2020.
We played them in the cup, didn't we?
Yeah, because I think I went to the 2-2 draw and then we won... Obviously at Anfield in the replay, didn't we? And I've got a little question about that later on. Although now I've just kind of realised that I am on my iPad, so can't get the answer.
I recall it's a really strange cup game because we played a really strong team for the two-all cup tie, yeah. And then played all the kids in the replay.
It was our youngest ever side in the replay.
It's normally the other way around, isn't it?
Yeah,
after you play the kids, they don't win, so you put the big guns out in the second game.
And it was the complete opposite. Yeah, Liverpool's average 11 that day, John, was 19.28. Right, this one might rival that, and actually we might be forced into playing some of our more experienced players because we kind of don't know what's going on with those players. So it actually might
just
not
playing any 11 you get older.
I think that's kind of where we're at the moment, isn't it? Anyway, obviously I'm joined by Ian Young and John Machen, as everyone can tell right now. We're going to get into it then. I mean, Ian, what's going on?
It's just nuts, isn't it? This is the world we live in right now. It's everything is like air on the side of the caution. You've just got to be super careful with everything you're doing. I think it's going to be sort of like when Carol Vorderman used to get the numbers, one from the first team, one from the under-23s, one from the under-18s. That's what the team's going to be. It's going to be, it could be an absolute mismatch. And we don't even know who's going to manage the team. We don't even know who's going to be on the sidelines either. It's so hard to predict what's going to happen on Sunday.
As it stands right now, John, Peter Kravitz is taking the press conference tomorrow. Therefore, I'm assuming that Jürgen hasn't tested negative today, but that does leave him time to test negative tomorrow and Sunday to be able to take the game.
Isn't he isolated for 7 days?
But we don't know the exact dates, do we? So yeah. I think I'm right in saying if he tests negative twice, he should be okay.
Yeah, but it's still the 7 days, regardless of whether he's tested negative, isn't it? And I don't think he went down till either Saturday or Sunday last week, so he's not going to have made till Saturday or Sunday this week.
So even then he can negative.
Yeah, as long as he gets his negative test in, he should be able to. He'd probably just get up in the morning, take his negative test, and right, I'm ready to go.
Ready to go.
Get the car down to Anfield.
And there we go.
And he's saying, right, who's playing today?
Yeah, who have we got? And Kravitz is like, not sure, mate. This is kind of the thing now, isn't it, Ian? Is like, Klopp was speaking a few weeks ago about clarity in this situation, and Liverpool were being very clear on who was out with COVID and who wasn't, and then all of a sudden he's gone, well, if you can't beat them, join them, and now we have no idea, which doesn't help us at all, by the way, of who actually has and hasn't got it in the squad.
Well, I assume because they hadn't given us the names, it was just too many names. It gone right through because we're all trained, because all our stages of the squad are train at the same place. I just thought it had gone right through and rife. I'm hoping that's not the case. I'm hoping we're all just, like I said, in on the side of caution and being a bit over negative and worrying about them type of things. But it could have gone right through the squad. I wouldn't be surprised if we were playing some under nines on Sunday. That's how worried I was. Because come on, when you close a training complex, because there's got to be big issues there for that to happen. It's not like you can sell 3 or 4 just to stay at home, is it?
Could have told us who didn't have it if it was that bad. You know, name the 3 players who haven't got it.
But then it might have... They know how fearful we are as a fan base anyway. We'd be like, who? Oh, God, the world's burning. Right, that's it. There's only 3 players that we've never heard of who are available for us.
You think when they closed the training complex, it was a bit like if they ever closed a school. You know, everyone's outside.
Yeah,
got a day off.
Yeah, they're like in my school, and Paul will remember this. It's like, it's too cold. What's the temperature? It's too cold. They've got to shut the school. Yeah. We're waiting for a snow day. Come on, it's too cold, and everyone's there like 15. One more. Come on, one more positive, and we get the day off. Come on, Liverpool.
You just know Andy Robbo's the one with the temperature. There was a thermometer as well going, but don't have to come in today.
So we know that some of the rules are different from the Carabao to the Premier League and the FA Cup. So whereas in the Premier League and the Carabao Cup, you have to pick players from a registered players list. Obviously, the FA Cup you don't, so it's anybody who means we can play under 23s or under 18s or anything, which does mean that it is likely right now that the game is going to go ahead. Shrewsbury have been in contact with the FA. Their manager's also been speaking to the FA, and he's been speaking to the press. He was actually more helpful than Liverpool's at this point, saying, as we undertake it, we spoke to them today, the game's still going ahead. So it looks like it's going to be probably a pretty full Anfield.
Yeah, I think the FA basically take the stance that it's a game of football, get on with it. You know, whoever you've got, you know, and Liverpool are there signing all their schoolboys up to contracts quickly. You know, you've got to sign that, right? Have your test, sign that.
All Premier League clubs have been instructed that FA Cup ties must be fulfilled and any registered player will be required to make up the numbers unless outbreaks are club-wide. So as it stands, we probably do have the players. I don't know where they've been training, maybe the mystery.
You can have Adrian playing centre-forward.
Didn't all the goalkeepers go down with COVID, though? That was the thing for the Arsenal game.
Alisson, though, he should be all right.
He should be coming back.
He can play centre-forward.
Goal scorer.
Get some crosses into the box.
It's just a bit mad, isn't it? Like, and Peter Kravitz taking the press conference as it stands tomorrow. Well,
to be honest, we needed to go ahead. We can't afford more fixtures piling up, can we? You know, we're already two down. Yeah. You know.
And that's the thing, isn't it? Like, Ian, we've got this game. We beat them with a 19-year-old average 11 last time out. They're a League One side. We should be expecting our under-23s with some of our first team players to go out there and beat Shrewsbury at Anfield.
I'd be expecting our under-23s to not walk all over Shrewsbury, but I'd be expecting our under-23s to go and get a result, maybe a 1-0 or something like we did at Anfield last time. If we have got the odd big name in there, like a Fabinho or a Virgil or whatever, you'd expect...
We might have to have them in.
Yeah, because they never played on Wednesday, and they're probably the only people... They might be the only players we've got who are... COVID-free, let's call it, they might have to play. So you've got to expect we'll go in there and get the result we need, just get the game done and get it over and done with, because the last thing we need is another replay.
Yeah.
I think it might be a nice experiment. You know, you get some of your proper first-team players, top professionals, going onto a football pitch to play someone they don't know anything about at all. They don't know what style they play, what formation, what players they've got, how fast they are, what corner of the penalty they take their penalties. It's no, nothing. Go on, lad, see what you can do.
Just magic up a win. Yeah. Magic up a win. And yeah, you actually don't know who you're going to be playing with until the day, because anyone could go down at any point. Yeah. You might, well, this is the thing, you might train, but they're not training. They're not training. So, like, what can you do at this point? It's pure ability at this point, isn't it? And if you haven't got Klopp and you're not going to have Linders there, and Kravitz, I think it's really interesting. I can't wait. Does he speak English? Have we ever seen Kravitz speak before, Ian?
To be fair, when you said Kravitz before, I thought you were talking about Lenny. So,
but he can sing, I know that.
But you just don't know, do you? It's the complete unknown. That's what it is. That's why. And you know what? We're sitting here thinking, what's going to happen Sunday? But it makes it very, very interesting. Whereas normally it'd just be a third round FA Cup tie, go in there, get the game done, move on to the next round. But this has probably made it more interesting than it was ever going to be. It's COVID, isn't it? It's just nuts. It's the world we live in right now. It's so unpredictable right now. You just don't know what's going to happen from one day to the next.
It's absolutely spot on.
The sports scientists must all be having nervous breakdowns. The thought of all these players going out onto the pitch not having trained.
It's madness, isn't it? Like, I mean, we'll come on to it in a little bit, because I was doing something with a sports scientist earlier on this week. Fascinating show. I'll come on to that in a bit. But I was looking on the Shrewsbury website. They've sold out their allocation. 5,672 fans coming to Anfield, which is... It's the thing I always forget about the early FA Cup round and all the FA Cup in general, because every year you sort of push it to one side. It's fucking boss seeing loads of the other opposition fans in Anfield, especially when I know they've been there recently, but it's a big day out for them. It makes the atmosphere great in the FA Cup, doesn't it?
I love the FA Cup, and that's one of the reasons. It's really exciting. The atmosphere you get is always brilliant, you know.
What? I mean, I do, I love it. Like, so hang on, I've got a trivia question for you then. Who scored the goal when we beat Shrewsbury in the fourth round replay in February 2020 to send Liverpool through. Who scored the goal when we beat Shrewsbury in the fourth round replay in February 2020? It wasn't that long ago, gentlemen. It's the FA Cup of competition we all love and respect. Oh, yes. I'm expecting the right answers from everybody here. I wouldn't have been able to get it at all.
For once, I know.
You do. Okay. And while you think and mull that one over, here's a clip from that aforementioned show I did with Simon Brundish. It is absolutely brilliant. It's on Redmen Plus. It's the Stats Show with me, Chris Pajak, and this week, Simon Brundish. Each week, I get somebody else to come in and do this show with me. This is the most fascinating show I've had the pleasure of doing for a year or two. I mean, it was absolutely brilliant. I learned something each and every time Simon opened his mouth. He's a sports scientist. He spoke about priming players. And if you don't know what that means, then you need this show in your life.
You have two centre-backs that play every game, right? In one game, your centre-back, your chief centre-back that plays every minute of every game, gets injured. So your third choice centre-back comes on, but he wasn't planned to be primed to be playing every week. So he has a chronic load from training only of 2 times, not 3. So he has a chronic load of 20K, not 30. And then suddenly he has to play 2 games a week and train. So he'll have more than a 30% increase in his workload.
Ah, you know what? I'm getting it now. Right. And this is when it's the prime that's the important part of all of this, isn't it? So this is when we're talking about your priming a player for a 9-month season is completely different for priming a cyclist for a 4-week tour of France, where they've got to peak in fucking July only at their absolute best.
Yes, so you want to get players of over the course of the 4 to 6 week pre-season up to being able to tolerate about 150 minutes of game minutes per week.
Right.
And you want them to be able to sustain that throughout a whole season for your better players, but that's really unlikely that you're going to get 11 players that can do that anyway. You're looking at players, most players can. The good players go for about 100 minutes a week average over the course of a season. So you're going to have to dip in and dip out of those and plan and periodize your season. If you think of, there's been lots of conversations over the years of Fergie and how he used to build in blocks over the course of the season. He would tell Scholes, right, you're not playing much in this block, but you'll be playing in the third block after the international break all the way through Christmas. So be ready for that. And over the course of the season, he will have his 100 minutes a week. But that he'll be fresh for Christmas when there are 13 games in 8 weeks, and he won't be used when there's one game a week for 4 weeks when they're going to use another player. So yeah, it kind of evens itself out. So you have to plan for these things, but the problem is only when you get multiple players injured in the same position, so they haven't been primed to be playing 2 games a week.
Hello, welcome back. It's the Uncensored Match Build-Up Show. It's Liverpool, it's Shrewsbury, it's FA Cup action this weekend. The question that I asked before the break, of course, was who scored the goal to send Liverpool through into the FA Cup fifth round the last time we played Shrewsbury in February 2020? And the answer, John Machin, is...
Some fellow I don't know scored an own goal.
It is the correct answer. Roshan Williams' own goal in the 75th minute. I'm sure it was just on the tip of your tongue, wasn't it, John? Before we get stuck into the Liverpool players who may or may not be available, Cameron, one of our YouTube members in the chat, you can see him right there at the top, says Coutinho to Villa at the Redmen TV. How do you feel about that? Ian, how do you feel about Coutinho to visit Villa?
I think it's a good move for Coutinho. I think it's a very good move for Aston Villa. I think it's a very good move for us because nobody's talked about him coming back to Liverpool for another 6 months now, which is constantly what we have on Twitter. I think he's what Villa will need. He's a step up from what they've got right now. And if he goes to Villa, he's not going to be sat on the benches. He's going to be getting the football that he wants. It's going to be an interesting one to watch, especially being managed by Steven Gerrard, who obviously he's played with. He knows Danny Ings there. Good luck to him.
John, what about you, mate?
Well, he's going to do something, hasn't he, to resurrect his career, because it's just gone down the pan since he left us.
Brutal. And facts.
I mean, Villa probably need to replace Grealish, because they're not really quite the same without him, are they?
Yes, true.
So, you know, it's probably a good move. I'm glad it's not us, to be honest. I wasn't a fan of him coming back to us. If we're going to get an ex-player, I think Wijnaldum would be a better choice than Coutinho right now. But no, thank good luck to him. I mean, I loved him as a player when he played for us. I thought he was brilliant. But, you know, I'm not sure he's a fit for us anymore.
Yeah, I must admit, for my 2 cents worth, as it were, or 2 pence worth, I should say, I think it could be a really exciting move for Phil Coutinho. We were talking in the office earlier, weren't we, Ian, about how, you know, for me, it's like, his career has gone down the pan. You're absolutely spot on. He's had 3 years where he's moved his family around. He's probably fucked his life up a little bit. He's definitely fucked his career up. And he's looking at it and going, I need to get back to some semblance of normality. I did well in England, spent 5-6 years there or whatever it was. And I've now got someone who trusts me because I played with him before. And that's after having three years plus of someone who doesn't trust him in charge of him. I think Steven Gerrard going, I played with you. I know what you can do. Just put that arm around them and go, you're not going to be the be-all and end-all of Aston Villa, but you're going to be a cog in a machine. You're going to be an important cog. And that's different if he goes to a top four club where you're probably in and out of the side. You're not able to get any rhythm up. In Aston Villa, he's going to get minutes. He's going to get a chance to resurrect his career. And it's a much better move. You mentioned it than Newcastle, because Newcastle, you do not know what's going on with Newcastle, what happens, whether they go up, whether they go down, or how they spend their money. Villa looks like a project that is being put together in the absolute right way, doesn't it?
Well, the only reason you go to Newcastle right now is probably because of the money they could offer you. That's it.
Yeah, absolutely spot on. Ashley Frith says Coutinho to Villa. Never saw that happen. Andrew Price got the question right. Roshan Williams, own goal. Well done, Andrew Price. Michael McGuinness has been a member for 18 months. Says, looking forward to Sunday. Go in the game. You'll never walk alone. I am too going
you
to the game.
You might walk alone.
Might be the only fella walking out on the pitch.
Mike
at this rate, Michael. Yeah, exactly. It's you versus Shrewsbury, average age of however old you are. So there you go. I'm going to go back to my agenda quickly because we've got some important stuff to talk about, and this I am going to need my agenda for. So it looks like, according to my screen, and you might want, yeah, I don't mind if you get the agenda up at this point, mate. It's a bit scrappy and stuff like that, but you know what? It is what it is. Defo okay right here. Virgil, Fabinho and Jones, they should definitely be okay. If Matip, Alisson and Firmino return negatives, they can train. Which leaves us a squad list of Trent, Nico, Connor Bradley, Joe Gomez, Konate, Robbo, Chimikas, they're kind of the defenders. Milner, Hendo, then Jota are the first teamers. So we're light midfield and very light strikers at the moment. Plus, we've got the likes of Kay Gordon, Harvey Davies, James Balaghese, Harvey Blair, Jarrell Kwanzaa, Elijah Dixon Bonner, James Norris, and obviously Leighton Clarkson came back from his loan from Blackburn. So he probably could play in the middle of the park as well. And I suppose there's an outside chance of Minamino and Origi are back. So, Ian, in fact, fuck it, John. What's your starting 11, mate?
Well, you know the Masked Singer?
Yeah.
Could have been a bit like that. I mean, I think Alisson and Matip and Van Dijk are probably nailed on to play if they're okay.
We're at the point here where you can't go too long without a game for these lads, can you?
No. Even that doesn't matter, though, does it? If the numbers are that bad, then you're just turfing out anyone who's okay. Yeah. I mean, of course, we're all thinking, oh, well, 7 days, they'll be okay. But, you know, I had it, and I was 18 days, I was still knackered, you know. So, I mean, I know they're much fitter and healthier than the rest of us.
Just but, a touch.
You know, it's always possible that one or two of them actually won't be ready for weeks, you know. But we're just assuming that after 7 days, they're all there chomping at the bit, ready to get on the pitch. But let's hope they are. But it's going to be difficult. I mean, we've got loads of options of fullback, you know, because we've got, apart from Trent and Robbo and Tsimikas, Nico, we've got Joe Gomez probably. I don't know where he is. We've no idea. Owen Beck, is he probably
okay, I think, yeah.
Yeah, so there's lots of options there. We'd be really unlucky if we can't pick two out of half a dozen fullbacks. And midfield, I mean, our midfield's been light for a few weeks now, so Curtis coming back in, that's probably really good for him to get a game under his belt, yeah, to be honest. And Firmino's playing as well, that's already quite a strong midfield, those two.
Yeah.
Forwards, I mean, that's the problem, though, because even before we start, we've got a really light forward line. Even if everyone was fit and healthy, we'd still be struggling a bit. But it is what it is. You just get on and do it, don't you? Might find a new forward.
Might do, or it could be an opportunity if he's fit and available for Kai Gordon.
I was just going to say, it could be Kai Gordon and he might push Neco Williams up front again like he did to play him out wide. Could be a case of play Cade on the right and say how Neco Williams does on the left, cutting in, see if we can have a couple of shots there. That's what he does for Wales, doesn't he? Listen, I'm pretty sure, I'm pretty hopeful that whatever team he put out should be able to do the job on Sunday, and that's the be-all and end-all. We need to get 3 points. We need to get through to the next round.
Yeah, absolutely. Michael McGuinness says, I honestly can't wait to see your squad prediction, Chris. It's going to be a laugh. So the Start 11 prediction show is up later on today. I don't know how, but I've dodged the bullet here. It's Machen. It's Paul who's coming in to do this one. I have no idea. I just wasn't roasted on for it, and I didn't ask questions. I was like, okay, sounds, I'll do the build-up show. No problem whatsoever. Paul's coming in to do the Start 11 prediction show. I think he might have already done it. You can't see it, but there's literally just a load of players on the board. That might just be it, to be honest with you.
Stick a pin in and...
Just guess. It's what he does anyway. He never picks a starting 11, your Paul. He picks options for each one because he doesn't want to be wrong. So he can't be wrong if you can't be right at the same time. So he just goes down the middle, which is fair play. Fair play. I'm wrong every week, so there's always that. I think the forwards is obviously very interesting, isn't it? We mentioned Kai Gordon there, Ian, and you've got Jota. I actually don't know where Ox is from my list here, so Ox could be an option.
He's been our only option as a forward in the last couple of weeks, hasn't he?
So it's likely that he's probably going to get a game as well. Yeah. We're probably going to see a pretty straight down the middle mix of youth and experience in this game. And if we can't beat Shrewsbury with that, Ian, fair play to them.
It's a chance for Shrewsbury, but if this weekend happened with Arsenal, I reckon we probably would have gone even weaker because we would have been resting players. Mm. I think because of the situation is, we're probably maybe because of what we've got available, we might be playing a stronger team than what we would have gone with originally.
Good point.
So the young lads that get to come in, it must be great that today being a young Liverpool player, today sitting on the edge of seat thinking, am I going to get a game on Sunday? Can you imagine being an 18, 19-year-old player who's been waiting to make
just
his
for the chance? An
there's a chance, yeah. They must be absolutely chomping at the bit to go on Sunday. And then if they're playing with the likes of Van Dijk and they're playing with the likes of Fabinho, and it's an even big, like, it's great making your Liverpool debut with a team that's full of kids anyway. But imagine coming into a team that's got Alisson in there and Virgil in there and.
That's the dream, isn't it? That's the dream. Deagle and Shores, thank you very much for the super chat, mate. Says, do you think it's going to be postponed, lads? I must admit, right now, I'm not sure it is going to be postponed.
No, I think it'll go ahead.
And there's another comment here from Little X. If the FA seriously make us forfeit due to the lack of players, it'll make a mockery of the competition. I don't think the FA are going to make us forfeit. And I don't think Liverpool... Here's the thing, I actually don't think Liverpool should postpone this fixture if they've got the players. Because... We could play any team from any division in English football. Like, it just happens that we're playing a League One side. We could have been playing a Conference side or lower down the divisions. You know, we could have been playing AFC Liverpool. Like, that's the cup. Their sides aren't as good as ours. Their squads aren't as good as ours. Like, if Liverpool go into the FA Cup, they should be allowed to use any player from any stage of this. The League Cup's slightly different because you have to be a league side and all that type of stuff, and the rules are different. But the FA Cup, man, that's the magic of the Cup almost, isn't it? You kind of do want to see Giant Killings. You want to see it level the playing field. You want to see a windy night sometimes.
Well, it's a different competition altogether, isn't it? I mean, basically, every one of us could have played in the FA Cup.
Yeah.
Because all you need to do is play for a very low-level team who've got a ground that's... meets the requirements. So, you know, it's really universal. It's a fabulous competition, really. And you really don't want anyone disrespecting it, you know.
Yeah.
I'm really looking forward to a game of football, if nothing else. So, yeah, bring it on.
So, how do we do score predictions for something like this? Is anyone going to throw anything out there? Cause it's going to be a disjointed side, isn't it, Ian?
Yeah.
And they don't normally perform particularly well.
I'm gonna go 3-1.
3-1.
I reckon Shrewsbury might pop one in.
Can you give me the midfield three?
I think Morton, Milner, probably Henderson.
Okay, John, what's your midfield three?
Well, Fabinho, because I think fairly certainly he's going to be fit. But say Curtis Jones and. It's tough. Who's going to be? Yeah, Jimmy Milner if he's fit.
I'm going to go Jimmy Milner. I think he might play the six. No, I'm going to go Morton. Jimmy Milner. Morton in the six. And.
It's the third one.
Because he might use Jones out wide. We were saying he was going to use Nico Willows. He might use Jones there.
Yeah. I'm going to go Clarkson, because a lad that's got a bit of football behind them as well, hopefully, from Blackburn. Let's go with the front three then. Jota.
And his two mates.
I'm going to go Gordon and Ox. Gordon right, Ox left.
Yeah, I think it depends if Minamino's playing.
Yeah.
You know, because I think he'll definitely play if he's fit and able. Otherwise, probably right Gordon and... Well, it could be Ox or it could be Curtis Jones, couldn't it?
What, yeah.
He might be worried about Jota getting injured. So he might go with Jones, Gordon and Ox up centre.
That's a good point. You don't really need Jota going down with an injury in this game, do you?
No.
That's a really good point. Actually, I might say I agree with that now. I think I'm going to change my mind and go, yeah, you can't, you just can't recover from Jota getting injured, can you? So no Fabinho, no Firmino then for any of us. Maybe Firmino, saying that you can't really afford him to get...
But then again, he could do with the game, couldn't he? Because he's not really played much football in quite a while. So, yeah, maybe he's a good shout.
Is the left-back as simple as you get Robbo minutes again?
If he's fit, I think. He hasn't played, he needs the game.
And right,
we're not
back,
playing again till Thursday, obviously.
No. Right-back, Nico? Over Trent?
Yeah,
Nico.
Full back, centre backs then?
I think Virgil and Matip will both play.
I reckon Virgil and Matip.
Matip needs those minutes again,
yeah,
doesn't he?
Yeah.
I think Konate might be the one to go in alongside
Cometio.
Him. I think Konate might go in alongside him and leave Virgil, because obviously Virgil's just coming back anyway. And obviously Alice.
Because we have no clue who's got it and who hasn't.
You don't know how any of them are feeling. They might be giving negative results, but you don't know how any of them are feeling after they've had it.
That's a good point. Yeah, so there you go. I mean, that's kind of it, really. I mean, there's not much more that we can add. So I'm going to get back into the comments. Michael McGuinness again, thank you so much for the super chat, mate. I can't see it getting postponed. All 20 Premier Leagues have been told they must play their FA Cup games this weekend. Rest first teams for Arsenal, play some kids. Yeah, that makes perfect sense. The AXA Training Centre has reopened, according to Owen Samuel. I'm just going to have a little look at Twitter and see if I can find something. I'll let you know if I do, Joe. Let's have a little look. I can't see anything just yet. That would be interesting. If they're training, that bodes well. Really well, in fact. Liverpool have today. Yes, we've got it. Liverpool have today reopened the AXA Training Centre. Peter Kravitz is leading preparations for Sunday's FA Cup tie versus Shrewsbury Town. So this is live now, 11 a.m. That looked like it was absolutely withheld information. Liverpool have reopened the AXA Training Centre as they prepare to return to action. The first team facilities at the Kirby base were shut down on a Wednesday as a result of major outbreak of COVID cases. However, it has now been deemed safe to reopen, and heavily depleted squad bolstered by youngsters from the under-23s and under-18s will train on Friday under the guidance of Peter Kravitz. The 50-year-old coach is in charge of preparations for the third round ties, Jürgen and Pep both isolating. Kravitz, who is nicknamed the Eye, has been part of Klopp's staff since the days together at Mainz. His responsibility is usually video analysis. Liverpool were already without 11 senior players before more positive COVID tests earlier this week. However, Sunday's game will go ahead, with the FA expecting clubs to use youth team players if required required in order to fulfil fixtures. That's kind of what we were saying, isn't it? The FA have said, use your youth.
Get on with it.
Get on with it. But at least we can train. So there you go. That is how you end the show.
It'll be Shrewsbury Town versus a Liverpool 11. That's what it'll say in the paper.
Good. And that's sound. So there you go. That has been the Uncensored Match Build-Up Show. I've been Chris Pajak. That's been Ian Young. And over there, between, like a rose between two thorns, is John Machin. Or a thorn between two roses. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Ta-ra.
Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you want more from us, consider joining Redmen Plus, our Liverpool streaming service. Like Netflix for Liverpool fans, fantastic documentaries, interviews, features, and learn more about the culture of the club, as well as bonus Redmen shows as well. And if you join as a club legend, you get your name there, theredmentv.com.